Hey everyone, how's it going? This is Ash, and welcome to my very first model train review video to come of February 2022. And this will be the very first model train review to come of the Lunar New Year of the Water Tiger. So let's kickstart this brand new Lunar New Year with a powerful model train, and in front of me is the Hornby Class 60, and I got this one for Christmas 2021, folks. But I'm super excited to do a review of this model, and to be honest with you, I did redo this video because I was not happy with the first take, so there will be some slight differences to what your model would be straight out of the box, as the open air dams are already fitted, and I will go more into that once we go into the review. Okay, anyways, let's have a look at the details first then, folks. The reference number on this one is R30027 Cappagh Class 60 CO-CO, named as Helvellyn, and is numbered as 60028. 00 gauge, folks, all there to see. It is a DCC ready model. You can use any 8-pin decoder as long as it's got a minimum of a 1 amp max output in terms of stall current. Should the locomotive get stuck on points and stuff, you should be grand, but I wouldn't recommend anything less than that. So that's just my experiences here, folks. And anyways, we are on the introduction. For the first time ever of buying a Hornby Class 60, I got this one from Gagemaster, by the way, folks. So I did take a leaf out of Sam's Trains video that he'd done back in January, and I've been doing this for a while. As you know, I never buy direct from the manufacturer. I always try to do my best to help the economy by buying from hobby stores and stuff. As one, it keeps more people in jobs, and two, I like to try and do the right thing, you know. But anyways, let's get this out of the box then. As you probably tell already, it's a very nice amount of weight on this one, folks. And before we go any further, we will cover the instructions and we will go to the ins and the outs of what actually comes with a model, okay? Obviously, you will need to buy the decoder separately. That's just for those of you that are new to UK model trains, okay? First and foremost, there is the instructions here, folks. And sadly, just like with the 2020 trio of Class 60s that I bought, such as the 2DB cargo ones and the Collis rail ones, you no longer get full flush air dams. But I promise you, I will go more into that once we get further into the review, okay? So here's the instructions, folks. Class 60, diesel electric locomotive, DCC ready, fitted and sound, operating and maintenance instructions. Now here's an interesting thing, folks. Can you tell me what's wrong with the instructions on this, please? Well, for those of you that are not familiar with UK trains, these are the diagrams of the Class 31. So here's my question to you. If any of you at Hornby may be watching this video, why have you chosen to put Class 31 drawings in the Class 60 instructions? Is there any reason for this, Hornby? Just curious. But anyways, just as to point that out there, folks, I have been collecting Class 60s and I've had more than my fair share over the years, right from when the model was first released back in 2006. And it's only the 2020 and the 2021 models that have the incorrect drawings, as the 2019 and before Hornby Class 60s, they had the correct pictograms. And another thing as well, they did come with full flush air dams as well, just to give you, the modeler, a choice. And that's my debate on this, folks. But quite a bizarre move, in my opinion, as to why Hornby have done that with the instructions. But I'm sure they must have their reasons. It's probably just an oversight on quality control. After all, none of us are immune from making mistakes, as we are all human. But anyways, I'm just going to place that down. Here is the bag of accessories. Now, one thing I want to point out, folks. Yours will still be with an extra coupler and the air dams. As when I did the first video, I did fit the air dams and I've secured them in place with a bit of black tack. Now, the reason for that is because they wouldn't stay on the model in terms of friction and they kept coming away. So I just used a wee bit of black tack just to hold those on. But you do get brake pipes and cosmetic couplers, but sadly, no flush air dams. And I really hope, upon reading Hornby's 2022 range and watching their video, and they are doing an upgrade to the Class 60 to the 21 pin circuit board, so you can use the newer decoders. However, I do hope that they will include full flush air dams and to give us an option, really, because at the end of the day, these models are not cheap to buy, folks, you know. But I'm just going to pop that in there. And the next thing we now need to do is to move on to opening up the box and, of course, have a look at the model. As you know, the problem with these models, folks, is you have to be very careful of the air horns, because they are made of plastic and they can break off if you don't pack these models very carefully, you know. And when moving them from the box, as I did mention in my review of the DB Cargo 60062, I had to repair the horns and the radio aerial on the rear cab. But anyways, we are finally presented with a very nicely made model here. And the air dams are already fitted, folks, but you will have to fit these yourselves, as they are in the bag originally. But I've used a bit of black tack just to hold these on, so they shouldn't go anywhere. Nice amount of weight, folks. The body is just clipped onto the chassis, so six clips in total, three on each side. Just pull it apart, just pull it outwards, lift the body off, and in you go. And fitting the decoder is very, very easy. And I have done a tutorial on this already, so please do check through my older videos on how to fit one if you want to. Now, very nice amount of weight. Sprung buffers. And nothing that a bit of Tamiya flat black will definitely take care of painting these, and I do recommend them. But otherwise, if you're happy with the model as it is, that's grand too. Another thing as well, we've got the NEM coupler fitted on the back, although the spring is very strong, so just be mindful of what wagons you decide to use with this, as you will see when I do the test run. But anyway, folks, I'm just going to let you have a look at the detail. You do get see-through grills, and I'll just wiggle my fingers in the background there. As you know, you can probably just see through the grills. I'm just making sure that I can get the light through there, okay. But all in all, it's a very nice model from Hornby, but we have yet to cover the close-ups and the rotation and also the performance test. But honestly, folks, because we no longer get full flush air dams and the instructions are incorrect, unfortunately, I'm going to have to knock a point off one, the quality, because it's definitely a quality control issue, and one on the features, as you no longer really have a choice without purchasing a third party pack of full flush air dams, just to finish the model off, you know. But other than that, it's still good points anyways for the model. And the next thing to do is for me to move on to the close-ups, then the rotation, and then the performance test. It's time for the close-ups, folks, and without further ado, I'm just going to jump straight in and aim for the cab. Starting from the front end at the top to the bottom, we'll start with the horns. These are separately fitted parts. They are plastic, and I would like to see Hornby upgrade these to metal, something like brass, which would be more robust, and it meant the horns more durable and less prone to breaking off. We do have separately fitted wipers, folks. I believe these could be plastic as well, or they could be wire. I'm not entirely sure, but I'd say plastic, which would be the latter, in my opinion. But anyways, separately fitted grab rail on the front, lamp holder, separately glazed headlights and tail lights as well. The model does come with day and night mode for the headlights only, but it does have full working tail lights. Although sadly, the model does have old technology, folks, so there is no option to turn off the tail lights when this locomotive is hauling a train. So if you do decide to get one of these and you're new to the Hornby models, just factor this in when buying the model class 60, okay? But if you're good with electronics and stuff, you could always modify the circuit boards to turn off the tail lights separately, but it would need a lot of work. If we just pan down further again, as I previously covered in the introduction, folks, the buffers are sprung. You can just use something like Tamiya flat black paint just to make these look more realistic, and just use a bit of satin black paint in the middle to represent buffer grease. So that would be another way you can enhance the model further. And I would recommend fitting a driver into this end, because this is cab number one, folks. So this end closest to the radiators is cab number one, as we're on the EMD class 66 and class 67s. It is the other end that is cab number one. So this one's kind of back to front, but that's how it was when Brush Traction built the class 60s back in the late 1980s to the early 1990s. And overall, there were 100 of these built in total, but one was scrapped in 2020 that was 60006, but there is still 99 of them still around, although majority of them are stored at Toten Traction Depot. We do have the NEM coupler pocket, and sadly no full flush air dams are included, as I previously mentioned. And I've just stuck this one on with a bit of black tack just to hold it in place, just so the model looks better on video, you know. On the trucks, folks, the footsteps, believe it or not, as well as the piping, it is separately fitted, although sadly the steps are not picked out with paint, nor is the piping on the trucks. The handrails are separately fitted, and the model does have opening doors, folks. However, these are plastic, and it would be nice to see Hornby update these to brass and just paint them. One, it'd make them more durable, and two, it just made the model look a lot better. And considering that the prices have increased considerably, it's not really a big ask to ask Hornby to do these kind of things. Also, the model doesn't have cab lights either, folks. So, as I said before, it is older technology. So, there's nothing really technology new on this model. However, that's changing this year with the newer models of 60001 and 002. If we just zoom on in, hopefully my camera won't blur. Just look at the crisp livery application there, the fleet number, the safety signs, as well as the data panel. Very nice and crisp, no distortions, all clear cut, very crisp, high quality tampo printing, as I do believe these are tampo printed on and are not decos. We got the Cappagh group of companies, and the Cappagh group is the parent company who owns DC Rail, and the other Class 6s that they own, as far as I know, is 6029, 6046, and respectively 6055. I'm not sure if they have any others, folks, as I believe they were going to buy 6038 as well, but that was never included in the deal, as 6029 was the chosen one instead. But anyways, carrying on, and as you can see here, very nice detailing on the top there as well. We've got the roof pad for the exhaust. We've got another see-through grill. However, there is no grills on the other side on the cab number two end, as there is, although the grills are etched and you can see through them when the body shell is removed, it's just for some cooling equipment and stuff. But anyways, just zoom in on the back. You can just see the cant rail, which is the reddish orange coloured stripe that goes across the top. We have the danger signs for the overhead wires as well. There is a radio pod. You can just see a glimpse of that on the back too. Just panning down. Same amount of detail on the trucks, just like we have with the front end. I'm just zooming out a wee bit because my autofocus is starting to have a mind of its own. We have a fuel gauge on the fuel tank there, folks, as well as some warning signs for the battery boxes too. So very extensively detailed there. We've got the compressor just behind the front truck. And again, folks, this one is also separately fitted parts as well. So you do get a wealth of separately fitted parts, but to be honest with you, folks, we got the same amount of wealth of detail parts fitted when the model first came out in 2006. Although there has been improvements, as the head and tail light modules are now connected with wires rather than unreliable and prone to corrosion tabs, which was the problem on the older models. Hornby have fixed this since around 2016, and that's a bold move, and I'm looking forward to the updates on the 2022 models when they go 21 pin. As you know, I do have mixed experiences with Hornby, although most of it's been positive, apart from the Network Rail Mark III DVT, which did have very bad light bleed. But anyway, folks, that's for another video. And that, my friends, is the close-ups all done. So the next thing to do is for me to move on to the full rotation. Right, folks, it's now time to move on to the next part of this review, and that's the full rotation. Being a UK locomotive, folks, it's going to be clockwise, okay? Just like I do with all UK model trains. And I will probably do this with the American model trains that I'm planning to review this year as well. But that'll be for another video, okay? But going clockwise round, the detail very much speaks for itself. I have installed the coupler onto the back, along with the open air dam as well, but all is there to see, folks. Well, as I try and say, all is there to see, folks. Very nice crisp livery application, just like with the near side. This is the offside, folks, as we do have cab number two on the left and cab number one on the right, and we're just coming round. Just bear with me. As you know, I'm fully zoomed out on the back of the train, right out on the camera, just so I can fit the whole train in. As you know, these are quite large diesel locomotives, so just having to adjust the camera to make it all fit. And that, my friends, is the rotation done. I'm just going to put the camera to its final position and lock the tripod. And it's now time to move on to the fun part. As you know, I have used a fairly heavy train just to test the traction, and I'm very certain that this model will pass with flying colours. So without further ado, let's move on to the fun part, shall we? Right folks, it's now time to start off the performance test, my friends. What I'm going to do first, I'm just going to reach over and turn on the background train. So just bear with me. We'll start that one off first, and then what we'll do, I'm just going to get that to a nice speed so it's not too fast and it's not too slow. And without further ado, let's turn on the power to the track of the Class 60 and let's just see how well this model performs. And we'll turn it up to about no more than 50% power. As you know, I don't go any higher than 50% for the reasons being it is a brand new model train and it is really recommended to give them a running session of around 30 to 45 minutes in each direction just to allow the driveline and the gearing to bed in. Of course, you can do what you want with your own model trains, but that's just the recommendation from the manufacturer, you know. But once you'll see after that period of time, the model will respond better as the driveline and the gearing beds in and settles down, and it won't be so erratic. Of course, some model trains can run silky smooth straight out of the box, and this Hornby Class 60 is no exception. As you know, it is a very strong puller. You do get all-wheel drive, as all six axles are powered. There's pickups on all axles. There is day-night mode for the headlights, folks. The only downside to this model is that you cannot turn off the taillights, and when Hornby did the update to the wired connections for the cab units where the headlights are, I was hoping that they would do something to give you an option to turn off the taillights. So, although I'm not going to knock a point off for that, it is just an advisory there. But hopefully, fingers crossed, we should see something in the 2022 models when they get updated to 21 pin, as I would like to see the functionality on DCC to be able to turn off the taillights. And I would like to see cab lights added to this model as well. Although if you know what you're doing, it's relatively easy to add the cab lights yourselves. Same with the engine room lights and stuff. And another thing I would like to wish for is that Hornby to add an illuminated dashboard to their Class 60 model. Although I have noticed something, folks. I'm just going to slow this train right down because I'm not sure if it's just me, but you may not see it so well on DC mode, but there is a wee bit of light bleed just to where the near side marker light is, folks. Although it may be a bit duller because I'm using DC mode, but on my example, if it was DCC, it would probably show the light bleed more, but there is only a wee bit of light bleed. It's not as bad as what the Mark III DVT is, but I'm going to have to take another point off the quality as well. So the detail is definitely 5 out of 5, folks. Although the features is a 4 out of 5, but I'm only going to give a 3 out of 5 on the quality, as light bleed should not be happening. And also as well, these models at recommended retail price are over £200. I believe it's around £207.99 from the 2021 prices. Although I got this one from Gauge Master for a bit cheaper than that, but it is £25 more that I paid for this model than what I paid for 6062 in 2020, the DB Cargo version. So, although I have nothing against Hornby, other than I wish they would fix their instructions, and I do wish they would quality check their models to make sure that the light bleed doesn't happen. It is a bit of a letdown, considering these models are not cheap. Things like this should not be happening. And I have read some horror stories about the LNER Class 800 having very bad light bleed on the driving units, where the headlights and the cab lights literally light bleed through the cab fronts to the point of it looking like a lava lamp. A bit like the problem I had with the Network Rail Mark III DVT, of which I haven't reviewed, and I won't be covering that in the video. For the matter is that I sent it back for a refund, but will this stop me buying Hornby models in the future? Maybe, maybe not. It depends on the prices. Although I will continue to buy Hornby, but it will probably be pre-owned. Although I will wait for other reviews on the new models, because if they have the problems fixed, then that will give me more faith and confidence in purchasing new models. As you know, I do my own thing, folks. I don't follow any trends, and I wouldn't boycott a company without giving it really solid consideration first, as I'm not that kind of person. And I've been a loyal Hornby customer for the best part of 32 years, folks, and I'm only 41. So Hornby is a brand that's been with me for most of my life, you know. But anyways, I do hope they will get on top of things, and I do wish them the best. And I certainly have no hard feelings towards the company, but I just wish for their quality control to improve, especially this year. Also, another thing as well, you may have noticed that I've used the KFA wagon behind the Class 60. Now, in the last video, there is a reason for this, because in the last video, unlike the other Class 60s, the spring on the back coupler is very, very strong, and it can derail any light wagons behind it. So just bear that in mind. If you don't have a heavy wagon behind the Class 60 that is stable enough to withstand the pressures of the spring, it will derail any lightweight wagons, even on this wide radius curve of Caddo uni track that I'm using. It will still derail, but the reason it hasn't on this one, because I used a heavier wagon just to stabilize the train that is being hauled on this test run. But as you know, solid runner, apart from the bugbears with the quality, it is still a fantastic model. and I'm pleased that the 21 pin upgrade is being implemented, and let's hope for cab lights and some extra better quality parts such as metal handrails, metal horns, just to give it a nice quality look. Although plastic's fine, metal does look a lot better. Just watch my Hattons Class 66 review, folks, and you'll see what I mean. As those handrails are metal. Anyways, two more passes and we shall switch the camera just so I can show you the tail lights on this model. One more pass and we're done. This view will show the tail lights on the model. Not overly bright, not too dull, unlike on the older models, which in some cases the tail lights were a bit too bright, but these ones seem to be at the correct ambience. However, it's definitely not prototypical for the Class 60 to have its tail lights turned on when hauling a train. So, although, as I said before, I'm not deducting any points off that, but it's just an advisory, and I would like to see Hornby either implement this on DCC where the user can turn the tail lights off when hauling a train, or add a switch to the lighting circuitry so the tail lights can be turned off with another switch on the fuel tank. And I would like to see that implemented on the 2022 models, especially considering Hornby has invested in the 21 pin upgrade. So I think they should do that at the same time, as then the model, they'll bring it up to date with all the other newer releases. But as you know, if you can hear a squeak, it's definitely not from the Class 60, folks. It's coming off the KFA wagon and the DVT on the test train in the background, which is just for the aesthetic purposes of this review. But honestly, I think this is a cracking model. Apart from what I've covered in the terms of the incorrect instructions and no flush air dams included, of which I have deducted 2 points off in terms of one for the quality and one for the features, as you don't really have much of a choice other than to use the included open air dams, or you will have to buy full flush ones separately. But anyways, and of course I've knocked another point off quality for the light bleed on the near side there, folks. I'm not sure if the camera is picking it up, but if you run this model on DCC it will show up clearer. But what I'm going to do, I'm not sending the model back, not for that wee bit of light bleed there. I'll fix that with a bit of black paint and I'll paint the inside of the body shell, but that's not the point. It's an easy fix for me, and I've been making model kits and stuff like Airfix and Revell and Tamiya and stuff since I was 9 years old, which was also the same year I got me Hornby trains. Since I've been buying Hornby trains myself, because in 1988 I did get the Midnight Freight. That was my very first Hornby train set. Although I started buying my own Hornby trains out of my pocket money and stuff from when I was 9 years old. And I've been a customer to Hornby for the best part of 32, going on 33 years now. But anyways, I'm going to do one more pass. And then after that, there'll be time to start winding down this review, folks. And I will be fair with the score. As you know, I'm a reasonable person. I just say it the way it is. I'm not a fanboy of any company or any brand. I treat everyone equally. But I just say it the way it is. So I'm not picking on Hornby. But I'm just concerned about the quality issues, that's all. Okay then folks, I hope you have enjoyed this video, and if you're still watching till now, I just want to say thanks for staying with me all the way through. As you know, I like to do unbiased, truthful reviews of model trains, model buses, and anything transport model related, as well as simulations and stuff. That's what my channel is all about, as well as real life transport, which I'm planning to do later in the year. Likewise folks, as I said before, I'm knocking 2 points off the quality. One is for the minor light bleed, for where the marker light is. And the other point lost on the quality is the incorrect instructions. And I have emailed Hornby about this, which was in the middle of last year. However, I didn't get a response. So I don't know if that's because they didn't receive my email, although it didn't come back to me as undelivered. So I'm assuming it was delivered, but I didn't get no comeback on that. But that's the reason I'm knocking 1 point off the quality, is for the incorrect instructions. As although I've collected these Class 60s for many years, and I know where everything goes, if a newcomer to the hobby has only just purchased one of these new Class 60s and they look at the instructions, they're going to be confused, as they may not know where the parts go. But I do have some advice for you. If you are new to the model train hobby, welcome aboard. But here's some advice. Have a look on Flickr for 60028 Cappagh, and that will show you where the pipes go, the colour coded brake pipes and stuff, as there's only two, a red one and a yellow one in the packet, and you can just fit those yourselves. Just use something like a wee drop of PVA glue or a bit of Copydex, as if you need to remove the brake pipes later, or if you've made a mistake, it's quite easy to manipulate where the parts go. And you can also use Copydex as an alternative to black tack when putting the air dams onto the model as well. So that's just a wee bit of modelling advice for you there folks, okay? I wouldn't recommend using super glue, as the reason is you'll get that horrible grey haze from the fumes, and that can also ruin the glazing as well. So I don't recommend using super glue. Also, there is companies like Kato and Prizer who actually make third party driver figures, and there's other companies as well, and I would recommend adding a driver into the leading cab just to enhance the model a bit more. And I will be doing that with mine. I'll be fixing the light bleed issue as well on my version, as I do intend to keep it folks, because I really do like the model. It is a cracking model. But the reason I've taken 3 points off the final score is two for the quality and one for the features. But the detail is definitely dead on. 5 out of 5. It's absolutely cracking. I really do love the details on these models, folks. That's why I do like the Hornby Class 60. And I've got to be honest, I will confess, it's my all-time favourite model from Hornby. Same with the HST. I like that one too. And I do plan to get some more of those. But I may go along the pre-owned route, unless I can see some reviews of the 2022 range of the HSTs. As I'm concerned about light bleed, and I don't like getting stung with low quality, considering as the prices have gone up, light bleed and stuff should not be happening, folks. That's just my opinion. But anyways, I'm rounding this review off with a 7 out of 10. As I think a 7 out of 10 for this model, factoring in the quality issues and the lack of full flush air dams, I think that is a very fair score. And I like to be fair to all model train manufacturers. But in all honesty, folks, that's my verdict on the model. I hope Hornby gets back on top of its quality control issues and does improve on this. And it will be interesting to see what the 2022 Class 6s will be like, as well as all the other models and stuff. So anyways, that's all for now. If you're still with me, big thank you for sticking with me right through to the end, as this is quite a long video, folks. And I will catch you in the next one. As I always say, please let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I do welcome your feedback. I'm open to debate. You may not always agree with what I say, and that's perfectly fine. I certainly won't delete your comment because you may have a different view to me, because, you know, that's what democracy is all about. Open-mindedness, respecting other people's opinions. And, you know, I don't do politics on this channel. I just do model trains and stuff. So I do like to hear your feedback and your opinions, as well as also your feedback on the quality of my videos, as I do listen to constructive feedback as well as positive feedback. So all in all, I just want to say this. Thanks for watching. Take care of yourselves and each other. All the best. God bless. And I'll catch you in the next one.